Good evening all. Today's topic is hypertension and diabetes, a vicious duo. Are hypertension and diabetes a common duo? Yes. Understanding the blood pressure. What is high blood pressure? High blood pressure means blood is pushing too hard against the walls of your blood vessels or arteries. Another name for high blood pressure is hypertension. Blood pressure is written as two numbers, systolic blood pressure, top number, and diastolic blood pressure, bottom number. Systolic blood pressure is when your heart beats. Diastolic blood pressure is bottom number when your heart rests between the beats. Understanding the BP readings. What is the normal blood pressure? When systolic blood pressure is less than 120 millimeters of mercury and diastolic blood pressure less than 80 millimeters of mercury, it is called normal blood pressure. And what is high blood pressure? When systolic blood pressure is 130 or above and diastolic blood pressure is 80 millimeters of mercury or above, we call it as high blood pressure or hypertension. What are the risk factors and causes for hypertension? One is obesity, and second one is sodium intake, and third one is alcohol and smoking and lack of physical activity. So a quick glimpse on diabetes next. What is diabetes? Characterized by high blood sugar or glucose levels because your body can either not produce insulin or does not produce insulin. So, what are the major types of diabetes? Type 1 diabetes, type 2 diabetes, and gestational diabetes. Type 1 diabetes, when the body does not produce enough insulin, we call it as type 1 diabetes, commonly seen in children. Patient needs insulin throughout his life to maintain blood sugars. And type 2 diabetes, body produces insulin but cannot use it well. And coming to the gestational diabetes, a temporary condition in pregnancy. And what are the symptoms of diabetes? One is frequent urination, thirst, weight loss, vision changes, and fatigue. And what are the consequences of diabetes? May result in uncontrolled diabetes, may result in stroke, blindness, heart attack, kidney failure, and amputation. And how to prevent it? Prevention by diet, physical activity, medication, and regular screening. Coming to the prevalence of hypertension in diabetes. Prevalence of the duo. So, 54% hypertension in the diabetic patients we commonly see. And 63% diagnosed with hypertension from the diabetic population. And coming to the hypertension in diabetic patients, it is commonly seen in age group 60 to 70 years. And in diabetes, patients suffering from diabetes more or less equal to 10 years duration. So, coming to hypertension and diabetes, why are they a vicious duo? See this slide. Diabetes, globally 285 million individuals are suffering from diabetes, 6% only projected, and by 2030, 439 million individuals are become diabetic, 8% projection. And globally, 970 million individuals are suffering from hypertension, and out of it, 26% were projected. And by 2030, 1.56 million individuals are suffered from hypertension, 29% will be projected. And 40 to 80% of diabetics have hypertension. Diabetics 2 times likely to develop hypertension. So, what are the complications of diabetes and hypertension put together? Coming to the microvascular complications, chronic kidney disease or diabetic kidney disease or retinopathy and neuropathy, more than 70% end-stage renal disease attributed to hypertension or diabetes mellitus, it is kidney failure. And increased risk of retinopathy is seen with the uncontrolled diabetes and hypertension. Coming to the peripheral vascular disease, diabetes mellitus increases risk by 2 to 4 times and increased risk in proportion to severity of BP. And coming to the heart, 3 times likely to have coronary heart disease and 2 times likely to have left ventricular hypertrophy. 3 times likely to have developed congestive heart failure. And brain, 2 times the risk of stroke. So, hypertension and diabetes, how is it linked? So, can hypertension cause diabetes? Yes. People with elevated blood pressure are at increased risk of diabetes. Out of 70% of patients with hypertension develop diabetes. 58% have raised systolic blood pressure of 20 millimeters of mercury and 52% have raised diastolic blood pressure of 10 millimeters of mercury. And how to prevent it? Prevention by maintaining healthy weight and doing exercise, stopping smoking and healthy diet. Can diabetes cause high blood pressure? Yes. Diabetes causes damage to the arteries and leading to high blood pressure. So, blood vessel damage results in heart attack or kidney failure. So, what is the major link or risk factor for this combination of hypertension and diabetes? There are 4 mainly risk factors. One is dyslipidemia and second one is obesity, third one is insulin resistance and fourth one is genes, genetic factor. What are the approaches for the treatment of diabetes and hypertension? So, lifestyle modification to lower blood pressure. And what is the treatment goal? Target blood pressure for patients with diabetes should be no more than 130 or 80 millimeters of mercury. Lifestyle modifications and potential reduction in systolic or diastolic blood pressure. So, by lifestyle modification like a 4.5 kilos weight loss result in 7 millimeters of systolic and 6 millimeters of diastolic blood pressure reduction. And according to American Heart Association, DASH diet, dietary approaches to stop hypertension diet results in reduction of 11.4 millimeters of systolic blood pressure and 5.5 millimeters of diastolic blood pressure. And restriction of the alcohol consumption, men less than 2 drinks per day and women less than 1 drink per day results in 3.9 millimeters of systolic blood pressure and 2.4 millimeters of diastolic blood pressure reduction. Coming to exercise, 30 to 60 minutes per day, 4 to 7 days per week, result in reduction of 4.9 millimeters of systolic blood pressure and 3.7 millimeters of diastolic blood pressure. So, restriction of dietary sodium to less than 2.4 grams per day result in reduction of 3.4 millimeters of systolic blood pressure and 1.9 millimeters of diastolic blood pressure. What is the DASH diet? A DASH diet means eating the following. So, high consumption of vegetables and fruits, high consumption of whole grains, moderate consumption of the lean meat, and low consumption of the salt. So, high consumption of vegetables and fruits. 4 to 5 servings each of vegetables and fruits, and high consumption of whole grains. 7 to 8 servings of whole grains and oatmeal or cornstarch or arrowroot starch. And moderate consumption of lean meat is 2 servings of lean meat, such as chicken, fish and rabbit meat or beef and pork. And low consumption means less salt and less saturated fats and sugar. So this is a sample exercise prescription plan for hypertensive patients. There are 3 phases in exercise: warm up phase, main exercise and cool down phase. Warm up phase, time is 5 to 20 minutes. Type is walking and stretching in light to moderate intensity. And main exercise is 20 to 40 minutes of aerobic exercise or 20 to 30 minutes of muscle strengthening exercise, moderate to vigorous in intensity. And coming to cool down phase, which lasts for 10 minutes, type is stretching muscles that were used and light to moderate in intensity. So, when to stop exercise? Signs to stop exercising. So, stop exercising and reach out for help when you experience any one of the following: pain or pressure in the chest, or shortness of breath, or pain in the left arm, or neck, or jaw discomfort, irregular heartbeat, blurred vision, feeling dizzy, nausea. All these indicate coronary heart disease. You must stop doing exercise and you must immediately consult the doctor. So, if I have diabetes, how can I prevent the emergence of hypertension? What can you do? First, control your blood sugar and stop smoking, limit alcohol, healthy diet with minimal salt and exercise. Visit your doctor regularly. So, know the nonsense. Metabolic syndrome. So, what is metabolic syndrome? Metabolic syndrome is a collection of conditions that often occur together and increase your risk of diabetes, stroke or heart disease. What are the components of the metabolic syndrome? One is obesity, mainly central obesity, high blood triglycerides and low levels of HDL cholesterol, insulin resistance and high blood pressure. So, reducing your risk of metabolic syndrome, what are the components? First is losing weight. Second is exercising regularly. Third is balanced diet to keep your blood pressure, cholesterol and blood sugar levels under control. And stopping smoking and limit alcohol. These are the steps to reduce the risk of metabolic syndrome. So, be responsible for your health. Yes, lifestyle modification is one way to maintain a healthy lifestyle. So, what are the diet do's and don'ts? So, recommended salt intake in a day for hypertensive patient is 2/3 of a teaspoon. That is 1500 mg of sodium per day if you have high blood pressure. Home cooked meals can help control salt intake. Always taste the food before adding salt. Avoid adding salt after the food is cooked. Best to avoid or limit alcohol. Men 2 drinks per day, women 1 drink per day. 1 drink means 5 ounces of wine or 2 ounces of beer or 1.5 ounce liquor. So, what are the right fats to eat? So, soy, canola, sunflower, oil are healthy fats. Coming to butter and lard, these should be avoided. And fish and flaxseed are the healthy fats. And fried baked foods with shortening should be avoided. And whole milks and cheese should be avoided. How to get your blood pressure checked? The first step in controlling your blood pressure is knowing your numbers, and that requires an accurate BP reading. Here is how to do it right, and whether you are at a clinic or at home. So what are the steps before, during, after checking the blood pressure? Before 30 minutes, in the 30 minutes before your BP is taken, you should not smoke, no smoking, no caffeine, no exercise. In the 5 minutes before your BP is taken, sit still. During measurement of BP, blood pressure, make sure the cuff in the right size and in the right place. Keep your cuff down on a flat surface like a table and at heart level. Sit upright, back straight, feet that on the floor, feet flat on the floor. Don't talk. After 1 minute, wait for 1 minute. After 1 minute, retake your BP. Average the readings. Consider the third reading. Keep a log and bring to every checkup. Bring your device yearly to make sure it is accurate. So, how to monitor your blood glucose levels? How to do it? A blood sample is taken and put it on the test strip. Strip is put into the blood glucose meter, and logbook is helpful. Aid in keeping track of blood glucose levels. Aim for target range. Your before meal, between 80 mg per deciliter and 130 mg per deciliter, and at bedtime between 100 mg per deciliter and 140 mg per deciliter. Majority of the patients with diabetes check their blood glucose reading at least 4 times a day before meals and at bedtime. So what are the myths about diabetes? Myths and facts. Myth: no one in my family has diabetes, so I won't get the disease. Fact is, family history is a risk factor for diabetes. However, many people with diabetes have no close family members with diabetes. So second myth is, I have borderline diabetes, so I don't need to worry. Fact is, pre-diabetes is the term used for those whose blood sugar levels are not in the diabetes range but are too high to be called normal. Pre-diabetes means that you are at high risk for developing diabetes within 10 years. Myth: it is not safe to exercise with diabetes. Fact is, getting regular exercise is an important part of managing diabetes. So coming to myths and facts of hypertension. Myth: high blood pressure runs in my family. There is nothing I can do to prevent it. Fact is, lifestyle choices have allowed many people with a family history of high blood pressure to avoid it themselves. Myth: I use kosher or sea salt when I cook instead of regular table salt. They are low sodium alternatives. Fact is, chemically kosher salt and sea salt are the same as the table salt, 40% sodium, and the count the same toward the total sodium consumption. Next myth is, I read that wine is good for the heart, which means I can drink as much as I want. Fact is, if you drink alcohol, including the red wine, do so in moderation. Heavy and regular use of alcohol can increase the blood pressure dramatically. So be responsible for your health. What are the key points? Increase the physical activity. Number one, maintain a healthy weight. Decrease the salt in your diet. Limit alcohol and do not smoke. Monitor your blood pressure and blood sugar at home. Take your medications properly. Thank you. Thank you for your patience.